So crazy, make them say, make it hot. So crazy, make them say. Been to the mountaintop, down to the valley, Philadelphia, Cali. Y'all feel me like Harry Fell Sally. Clothes exotic, flows erotic. No jewels, that's for them fools who ain't got it. Rap to my own sitcom, now I just sitcom. Watching y'all respond to my July 4th bump. I'm a nice kid, but here's some advice, kid. Don't get me hyped, I set it off like my wife did. Plan down pat like Sajak, wheel a fortune away. Price ain't right, I don't play. Find yourself in jeopardy. The first clue.
We got another special guest. He is a former contest winner of mine. He's coming back to defend the title tonight. Give it up for Chris Williams. What's going on, Atlantic City?
Right. I'm gonna say something right now. Cut that shit off, man. Goddamn. That's all loaded shit now. We heard it too many damn times now. Robin ain't even with Paula no more, man. You know that. We can't hear that shit anymore. I gotta say something, man. I told people I had a show, and they're like, oh, okay, cool. They tried to text me today to get here, and I wasn't responding. So they started threatening me, like, hey, man, as soon as I get there, I'm gonna heckle you. Like, really? My own close friends and family? So right now, to get that out of the way, because I know somebody's going to try to boo me, this asshole right here, he works with me. You know what I mean? What we're going to do is, everyone, just get out of your system. On the count of three, just boo as loud as you can. Just do it. Bring it up. There you go. All right, hey. I got shit to do today. All right. So my thing is this, man. You know, you got it out of your system, now it's time for greatness, okay? And you know what's great? That the Rebel just closed down. Who's sick of that place? It's too goddamn expensive. Every time someone said Rebel, I just checked my bank account. I go, shit, how much I got left? Goddamn. And ain't nobody trying to get on the elevator and see the ghost of Ray Rice's girlfriend because he's gonna beat her ass so bad. Let me be honest with you, it's not a good year for black people on the elevator. Jay-Z got beat up. Any brothers in here? Any brothers? Guys, listen, I see you in the back through the smoke because you're dark. Listen to me. No elevator today. Just take the fucking stairs. We ain't doing well in elevators. It's crazy, man. Atlantic City and the people in Atlantic City still looking fucked up. You ever go down the boardwalk for like an outside Walmart? You're like, what the fuck? Where am I? There should be a bar like every three steps. I need a drink because I just seen somebody with no arm and no dick. Damn, pick a struggle. Have no dick or have no arm. God damn. It's crazy, man. And being out here is like, it makes you feel weird. Like, you stand in line at Dunkin' Donuts. Like, why do you stand in line behind someone look like they've been ducking bullets all day? Where the fuck are we at? And then I was in a hotel room and I realized this place is shady. The tap water tastes like Keystone Light. Does that ever happen to you? You're like, God damn, I went to brush my teeth, ended up drunk. Came downstairs in the lobby. This happened recently. I'm not going to tell you where, but it happened. I come down the lobby. I started stumbling down the lobby. I just started saying fucked up shit. Somebody tapped her girlfriend like, baby, look, he brushed his teeth. Look at his smile. But he's wasted, though. Oh, man, look at him go. I'm just coming down like, hey, listen. They trying to make a Ghostbusters 3 without Bill Murray. They better fucking stop. You know, I seen a goddamn midget at Six Flags. And I said, fuck you doing? Sightseeing. Hey, and stop talking about Obama. This ain't happy with you. Bitch. Now, excuse me, I'm gonna go take a fucking shower. I went to take a shower, forgetting that the tap water's Keystone Light, ended up in the hospital. It's 3 weeks straight. They said I woke up and they found me with a bar of soap, a loofah, and semen everywhere. Officer said 90% of it wasn't even mine. I said, don't explain the story, I'm going home. It's crazy, man, it's crazy. It's crazy. Just being out here is a good feeling, man. How y'all feeling now? Y'all feeling good? Right. I got a couple friends and family here. Matt said, hey, where are all the black people at? You know where they actually were when he said that? They were being held up in line outside. And then as he said it, I go outside, all the black people standing there looking like the DMV. My friend Monroe texts me like, this is Zach words. He's like, nigga, why we gotta wait? Adam. He got his master's, you know, black people with the master's, like they do whatever the fuck they wanna do. They're like, I got a master's and I'm black. Like, goddamn, double touchdown, baby. It's crazy, man, it's crazy, man. You know what I don't understand? What's even crazier is how, you know, we say this slogan out here in New Jersey, we're stronger than the storm. We're stronger than the storm. No, we're not. We have a governor that's fat as hell. He ain't even stronger than a goddamn diet. You know what I mean? See, those are Democrats. The Republicans over here and shit? Y'all ain't fucking with black people. Who said the year? Is that you? Yeah, nigga, I see you. You like, turn down or what? But it's like, we're not stronger than a storm at all. Like, every time it rains, 1 in 10 people die in each town. We ain't strong as shit, we never prepared. We just got strong enough to cancel another season of Jersey Shore, thank God. That's what we strong. Give it up for that shit. I was tired of that show. Imagine a black Jersey Shore. Nothing but smoking weed, sitting around fighting. And why you keep cheating on me, Pookie? God, Pookie keep cheating every season. Nothing but babies. We're just being in the hospital every season finale, delivering another one. And here's Michael Jordan. Every NBA player comes from a season of the black Jersey Shore. But what I don't understand right here, people, I'll tell you right now. Malaysian Airlines. You know about these motherfuckers, right? How you lose a plane, man? The whole place. Now, my thing is, you know when you go to the airlines, they lose your luggage. How the fuck you lose a plane? That's your job, man. Imagine he show up, the DJ show up. He's like, I ain't got my vinyls. No vinyls. No vinyls. No music. Motherfucker, you show up without music? You're the DJ. How do you lose a plane? Now, I want to bring you into this. They're losing planes. My thing is like this, okay? When you go down a tunnel, what is it like being in Malaysian Airlines? You're walking down the tunnel. They're probably doing the young jock. All the stewards doing young, rip your chicken like, dun, 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 dun. Malaysia Airlines, we going down, even over water, we going down, over Ukraine, got shot down. Anytime you fly with us, no, we going down. God damn, is going down airlines? Nigga, don't get on the plane. I heard they have good snacks though. Let's eat some snacks. No, motherfucker. How do you get on a plane where the pilot is hysterically laughing next to you? He's just like, hey man, we ain't even land a flight. Why would you even get? I'm out, man. It's crazy. I'd rather see Denzel take a drink and fly me to anywhere else than get on Malaysian Airlines. At least only 3 people gonna die. It's crazy, man. Imagine a commercial from Malaysian Air. Imagine that commercial. You know they have drugstore commercials where people are like, okay, a vitamin. You take this, you get heartburn, indigestion, this, that, and that. You know the deal, right? Imagine a warning on Malaysian Air. They're just like, Malaysian Air, fly with Malaysian Air. And then the warning guy shows up. You look good. The warning guy just shows up. He's just like, Malaysian Air, warning signs may cause loss of sight, loss of life, loss of limb, insufficient car trouble, baby mama drama, may not see your family again, may have to be in the blue velvet room and watch people do comedy and pay a little bit you didn't want to do. Just be crazy, man. Be crazy. But what is crazy is these women out here. Now, there's a couple women here I want to shout out. We got Maylene over here in the orange dress. I want to take a look at Maylene because she's looking good. Now, if you saw her husband, you'd be like, damn, he's a pimp. Like, this guy right here. It's got the Boricua of all time. You know what I mean? And when you deal with Spanish women, I don't know how you do it, because they look crazy. They do crazy shit. No other woman is going to blow your car up, burn your clothes, stab your brains, but still have dinner on the table by 7. Nothing but Maylene. She's like, oh yeah, you know me, papi. And the funny thing is, I know for a fact this guy don't know no fucking Spanish. You know what I mean? I'm sitting on Rosetta Stone, he don't even give a fuck. He don't even know what Ola is. It's crazy, man. But I like crazy women, I'm weird like that. I like crazy chicks. You know what I mean? Like, for some reason, like, you know, feeling like my life is in danger kind of turns me on. But I know the warning signs to get away. Like, when my girl's favorite, you know, role play position is being held at gunpoint, I think we got a problem. You know what I mean? I think we got a serious problem. But also, real shit, is how much mist is here? Are they overdoing it? Like, I feel like Dr. Dre and Snoop up here. Da-da-da-da-da. It's a motherfucker. Like, what is all this smoke about? We had enough. Turn the smoke machine off in this bitch. Jesus, man, Jesus. So how you guys feel in Atlantic City? We good? Real quick, before I end the set, I do want to say this. As a comedian, you know, people die and things like that. We did lose Robin Williams. You guys get to clap for Robin Williams. Everybody loves Robin Williams. So how many people are here from maybe Philly or they watch Philly News? Anybody here watch Philly News, local news, Philly? How bad is Philly News getting though? Every time you turn on the news, you feel like you gotta get up and lock your doors. The news is getting real. It's like 30 minutes of pain, ain't it? Every time you go turn it on, it's like, and 98-year-old Amber was raped. You just pass the fuck out. But then you wake up and realize maybe Amber should have been raped because why was raping 20-year-old? It's too much of this. Amber don't give a fuck. She's raped. You know what I mean? It's crazy, man. But one thing I did notice about the news, every time something crazy happens, they send Vernon Odin to the scene. He's always on the scene. Like, they'll be like, hey, there's a gas leak. Get that nigga Vernon. Every time. And Vernon's always in, like, the craziest places. It's like, he's like, can you send Cecily Tynan? Cecily, don't leave the studio, Vernon. Get out there, man. Vernon Odin's been in the streets so long, he got street smarts now. You ever see Vernon Odin? He's a real dude. Like, I never met him. I don't want to. He pulls up to the scene, and he's just like, and live from North Philadelphia, it is Vernon Odin. And cut. All right, yo, 20 on the dice game, 20 on the dice game, 20 on the dice game, 20 on the dice game. Oh, oh, that's me, that's me. Then Rick Williams comes up. I got it, I'm in it. Oh, oh, Yuki Washington's up top, like, whoop, whoop, police. It's police, man. Man, all the black gangsters are thugs. All of them are thugs. Y'all don't even know it, man. Y'all don't even know it. But ladies and gentlemen, you guys have been great tonight at Blue Velvet Room in Atlantic City. Thank you very much. My name is Chris Williams. That's my son. Make him say, make him hot. Take me away. Go crazy. Make him say, come on.